ஓம் ஸ்ரீ சாய்ராம். பிரணாம்ஸ் அட் தி லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட் ஆஃப் பிலவட் பகவான். டியர் டியர் பகவான், யூ ஹவ் பிளஸ்ட் அஸ் ஸோ மச் தட் வி ஆர் ஏபிள் டு லிவ் லிசனிங் டு யுவர் நேம், சிங்கிங் யுவர் க்ளோரி, ப்ரேசிங் யுவர் க்ளோரி. We are very grateful for blessing us to enter us into the 50th Golden Jubilee SAMARPAN program today. Throughout the world, they wish everyone happy Father's Day. Our Father is always blissful. From the bliss, out of the happiness, He thought for 50th SAMARPAN program, He wants to have His own first batch student from Prashanilayam, Shri Sai Surendranath. In 1977 to 79, in Vrindavan, he did his intermediate. 79, Swami opened his Prashanthilayam campus, first batch for his BCom, first batch for MCom, and after that Swami selected him as first student as a postgraduate teacher in Sri Satya Sai Higher Secondary School. And today I am standing in front of you because we both were batchmates. Once we enter the portals of Swami, we travel together in the world. Whichever part we may be, we are traveling. I am very happy and blessed that today Swami has blessed Sai Surendranath. I am here to share one more thing. He is first in everything. And also when we were studying, with Swami's blessing, we started the bhajan group. First music program was me on the violin and Sai Surendranath on the tabla. Not only that, when we sit in the musical mood, the bhajan Stumuho Vigna Vinasha, Madhava Mohana Shyama Gopala, Vinati Karume Bar Bar Sai, together we compose those bhajans. And today Swami has blessed me to be here to introduce him. It is a great opportunity, blessing, that he has selected Sai Surendranath today for this Golden Jubilee celebration, 50th month of SAMARPAN, because he talks from the heart. He always thinks. I know him from the student's time. He always reacted for everything from the heart. Naturally, Swami loves heart-to-heart people. So today, we are going to have here our dear, dear, dear brother, Sai Surendranath. Jai Sai Ram.
Om Shri Sai Ram. I offer my humble pranams at the lotus feet of our most beloved Lord. Respected elders, my dear brothers and sisters of Sai family, my dear, dear students, colleagues, and the most important group, Team SAMARPAN, my greetings to all of you. Thank you, SAMARPAN group, for inviting me here on this stage where many shared beautiful moments with our sweet Lord. Thank you for that opportunity wherein I too can share with you, relive those wonderful moments with our beloved Lord, our mother, our father, and everything. Give a big round of applause for the team SAMARPAN. I didn't know that this was the 50th episode of SAMARPAN. Thank you for inviting me. I hope I will do justice and take you all along with me in the memory lane. My topic today is Sai, our eternal companion. Yes, we will be having no address without Sai. With Sai, we are everything. Without Sai, we are nothing. I just wanted to share a beautiful moments where in olden days, Bhagavan Baba used to give a visiting card to few of his chosen devotees. And this is this card. In that, his beautiful signature, lovely photograph of Swami, and of course, his worldly address, too mentioned. But the best part of this was, when you turn back this visiting card, you will find profound statement which Swami used to claim on those days. Satya is my prachar. Dharma is my achar. Shanti is my swabhav. And prema is my swarup. Today, I thought, why not I string the rich experience living with God for almost from my birth, say 57 years, and my physical association with Swami for 35 years living in Prashanthi Nilayam. I thought I will string some of my rich experience, memorable ones, which always I cherish, I relive every time. It recharges me and motivates me and make me live alive today. And I thought I will string that with this profound statement, Satya is my prachar, Dharma is my achar, Shanti my swabhav, and prema my swarup. Let's take up one by one. Satya is my prachar. We all know this little young lad in a remote village in Andhra Pradesh, Puttaparthi. Suddenly one day, he told all his family members and relatives, look here, I am no more your Satyanarayana Raju. I am Sai Baba. You know, I have my devotees waiting. There is a great mission to accomplish. This is the statement that he declared. And as a young lad, when Satyanarayana declared that he is Sai Baba, and my devotees are waiting, and I have a great mission to accomplish, what happened thereafter? That insignificant, unknown, small village, which nobody could identify those days, he converted that place into a great place of importance. Today, Puttaparthi or Prashanthi Nilayam is in road map, rail map, air map, medical map, educational map, spiritual center, international center, what not. He has converted that insignificant unknown village and gave such great importance. And the best part is, you and me and all of us are part of that great mission, and that is why we think of him, we love him, and we are here. So therefore, what do you understand from that? Truth prevailed. What was the statement? Satya is my prachar. And he lived up to it. Okay, I will switch over to one of my personal experience with our beloved Lord. We used to come to Puttaparthi. Before that, I want to say this part. I was really blessed by, immensely blessed by our sweet Lord, to be born in a family where they already were the devotees of Bhagavan Baba. Just by mere birth, I'm able to accept him as my God, as my guru. My father was the vice president of Bhajana Mandali those days in Chennai. And in our house, early morning Suprabhatam, Omkaram Suprabhatam, Nagar Sankirtan, Bhajans, and various other spiritual activities used to take place. And my father was the vice president of that, very famous Bhajan center those days. And I used to participate in all that. My parents told me, he is your guru and he is your God. And I had no option other than accepting it. And this Lord, we used to travel from Chennai and come to Prashanthi Nilayam. My maternal grandmother, by name Pankajamma, popularly Swami used to call her as Chautamma because she can't hear. A group of devotees from Chennai, olden days, they all used to come. She was the main link for our entire family, a binding link with our sweet Lord. And we used to come from Chennai by train those days. I still vividly remember my young days. Get down in Penukonda, take a jatkawala, that is horse-driven cart, sit into that, and in Kacha Road, dum, 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 you will get many Shivalingams on your head, hitting on all the sides. And then finally reach Bukapatnam and reload yourself in another vehicle, Bulakat. And there on Bulakat, ladies, children and luggage. And men used to push the Bulakat because the Bulakat needs to cross the Chitravati River. That's the only way. And even today that road remains. So they used to push the Bulakat and finally we reach Prashanthi Nilayam, the abode of peace. That was a fantastic pilgrimage those days. With lot of discomfort, there was joy, excitement, piousness, earning, craving to see that sweet Lord. Great pilgrimage. But we never used to think about all that. But we reached Prashanthi Nilayam. And for your information, those days, whenever people come to Prashanthi Nilayam, very difficult to come. So they can't come like today. They come in the morning and get back in the evening, which was not possible those days. So they used to come, stay for at least a week, fortnight. Sometimes some people stay for a month or more. And we used to frequent Prashanthi Nilayam from Chennai. And we used to get good number of interviews from Bhagavan Baba. Those days the tradition, please remember, if you want to leave Prashanthi Nilayam after staying, Swami knows and each and every soul that comes to Prashanthi Nilayam, you want to leave without his divine blessings and permission, you cannot. So he will summon, he will call you, give you vibhuti packet and namaskar, and most of the time the families will be called for a beautiful interview session and blessings, immense blessings. And then only you can say goodbye to Prashanthi Nilayam. That was the golden days, an era where the love was flowing without any limitation. One such day, when we were there, we too wanted to leave after a long time, and Swami called us for an interview because we wanted to go. Though we got many times interviews, that time, during the course of talking, Swami became very serious and looked at my mom and said, "Hey, chala kashtapadtaru meeru. You will face a lot of problems." When Swami tells that you will face a lot of problems, it is going to be a real problem. Because Swami telling that you are a problem is not going to be a problem, it will be a pell-mell. So finally, my mother wanted to sort out. She asked, "Swami, any problem?" Then Swami said, "All your money will be gone. The jewelry what you are wearing will go. There will not be peace in your family. Husband and wife will fight. relatives of yours will play havoc in the middle. And a time will come that you say, "Cha, what is this Sai Baba? This Sai Baba is giving me trouble, but not peace of mind." And you will take my photo and throw out of the house. To that extent, things are going to happen. Imagine somebody is standing in front of you and predicting all these things. What will happen? You will shiver through your pants. But my mother, because of Swami's blessings, immediately fell on Swami's feet, held on to that Swami's feet and said, "Swami, please, whatever may be the condition, even if we don't believe you, even if we don't trust you, even if we leave you and go, Swami, please, you don't leave us." Do you know for that what Swami said? With a beautiful smile, "Pichidana, do you know kite? Galipatam chala duranlo untundi. Kani a galipatam vadilevadu chetulo thadu untundi. Naaku telusu eppudu cheskovalo. Kite will waver, will wither, and it will go far away and far away from me. But remember, the rope is in my hand. The thread is in my hand. You cannot, whatever distance that you go, a time will come. I will pull you closer and closer to me, and I will not forsake you." That was the assurance Bhagavan Baba gave on that interview. With some kind of consolation and a token of love, we left Prashanthi Nilayam, reached Chennai. First 6 to 9 months, everything was fine. Nothing happened. We forgot what Swami cautioned us or mentioned to us. That is the Leela of Baba. We just forgot about it. And then whatever Swami predicted in the interview room started unfolding one by one, one by one. But with more intensity, with more trouble. But he told us lightly, but this was like hammering session. It went on. Really a time came that we never believed. I told you, Bhajan Center was in our house. We shifted to some other house. 7-8 years, Sai Baba was out of our syllabus. He was never there in our mind, in our heart. We never thought of him. But only trouble and trouble and all the trouble, more and more trouble, only trouble. Trouble troubled us. In that trouble, we never thought of anything else, but immersed ourselves in trouble. After 8 years, suddenly I developed some health problem. I used to get chest pain. I felt that maybe some cramp or some muscle catch or pull or something of that kind. The intensity of the pain, quite often when it was repeating, it became more and more. Then 1 month, it was very, very bad, very intense. And that time, when the pain was more, I was profusely sweating as if I had a bath. All my clothes were drenched. My left hand slowly became weak and numbness. And I could not breathe because any small movement gives me excruciating pain, like 1,000 needles are pricking. And the whole hall where I was sitting went blank and dark. From young age, I all the time used to listen to Baba's discourse. And Baba all the time was telling, how you live is not important. How you leave the body is very important. How you die is very important. So that flashed in my mind. And I knew, damn it, my time is up. I have to pack up. So immediately, I saw in that hall, you know, day-to-day calendar will be there. Every day you tear, no, that calendar. What was that god there? Our Kula Devatam. That is Lord Venkateshwara. Picture was there. I knew it is all done. And I saw that picture and I told my dad, get me the picture and I'm going. Get me the picture, I'm going. My father panicked. Tension, confusion. Everybody in the house screaming, shouting, whatnot. The only son, because they had one elder son, he was no more. So they didn't want me also to go. So that was their condition. My father ran to the altar. And in 1951, Swami created a photograph for my father. And that was just lying in the altar. He picked that photograph that day, rushed and put it on my chest. He said, Baba, save him. I believed in you. Don't take away my son. And he bashed on my chest. That second, I could breathe nicely. And then slowly, light started. That means from that Lord Venkateshwara, I could see his creation too, slowly and slowly. And then they gave me water. By then, I was seeing my avatar. Servant made maybe ginger paste and they applied here. You know, all that Ayurvedic stuff. All the experiments must have gone on my system to revive me, to make me survive. Anyway, doctor was summoned. Then ECG and this and that, everything was done. And then doctor declared, your son had an heart attack. My father said, what? Heart attack? He's just 14, 15 years. How can he get heart attack? He said, no, sir. One in 10,000 cases this happened, and your son is that one case. Oh, we all thought, gone case. So what is the next thing to do now? Immediately, my dad and my mom and my sister, we all decided, pack up. Pack up where? Back to square one. Journey to Prashanti Nilayam. After 8 long years, there he was with me as an excuse, started pulling me back and pulling entire family back to his lotus feet. And there when we came, as usual, you know, the mischievous, sweet little Krishna ignored us as if we are first timers. Hey, who are you? And all that kind of stuff. He used to regularly take up letter from my mother asking for an interview. Same thing happens with my father, but very religiously, meticulously, he repeated the performance every time when these two gave letter, very lovingly extended his hand, but never extended the hope. The hope is survive. But finally, what happened? 3 long months. In these 3 long months, doctor told me, no weightlifting, boy. Totally rest. And I was doing MBPC. He said, no college. Take rest. All that big list of do's and don'ts was given to me. And then finally, that time, I was watering the entire Prashanti Nilayam with one gentleman by name Basant, who looked after Sai Gita, elephant Sai Gita. I used to help him. Then I was in the bookstall. When the stock comes, I used to take the stock, count the books, and reorganize everything. You know that Gopuram is there? In that Gopuram, there are different small windows you can see. That was the go-down those days for Satya Sai books and publication, all the things. I used to carry books and keep it on top. And I go to canteen, serve water, lift the dirty plates there. All this hangama I was doing continuously for 3 months. And after 3 months, one day, Swami those days used to come first gen side and then only ladies side. So from the interview room, he came gen side. From that slope only, hey, he said. So immediately, Swami's calling. Hey, you. I said, Swami's calling. Then Swami said, you. Me? My God. 3 months it was always bouncers, either left and right and top and bottom, but never in the center. And now it was totally focused on us. He said, you guys, come on. Full of enthusiasm and love and that, excitement. We rushed. We left Swami here, not bothered. We don't know to whom you're going to talk. We just left Swami and started running towards the interview room. And we had a big list of things that we need to ask Swami. And then finally, Swami entered. And then first thing Swami said, Pendli, Pendli, Pendli. Said, what is Pendli? Then Swami said, my sister should get married. And Swami told me, you must study. And then finally, I joined here, 77, as my brother Arihiran told. I completed my intermediate here. And then Swami used to tell me, I'm going to start a university in Prashanthi Nilayam. Anybody interested in joining? I used to raise hand. And 18 boys were selected. And we were there in Prashanthi Nilayam as a first batch. Completed BCom, completed MCom as first batch. And I also applied for a PhD. Meanwhile, in the higher secondary school, they wanted a commerce teacher. And they told Swami that it'll be nice if this guy comes and teaches. And then finally, Swami asked me one day, Era Upanyasam Istava. I said, Swami, whatever you say, I will do. I have nothing in my head. Swami said, Vellu, Velli, call higher secondary school, Cheru. Hey, Habu, no interviews, no procedures. Give him the textbook, show him the classroom, and he will start teaching. And that's how very easily I got the job. And 1984, and now it is 2014, I have successfully completed 30 batches with help of Bhagavan, and my students are here in front of me. Swami's assurance. That kite, when Swami drew us, my father was given the opportunity by Swami to serve in the canteen. My mother and sister as Sevadal and also part of Bhajan group. From that day till date, we are here. What more? And I am 57 years. My heart is still beating and nothing happened by Swami's grace. What more you need to prove that he is true? Satya. Satyam is my prachar. And this beautiful assurance, I will protect you like eyelids protect the eyes. You always have me and I have you. I will never leave you and you can never leave me. That is the attachment between God and devotee. Many wanted to know this most favorite, my Benz experience, because many wanted me to repeat. I am repeating. 1979-80, first batch, our hostel and college were under construction, and all these Brindavan boys used to stay in the old hostel opposite to the Swami's Mandir. And we are permitted to sleep in the portico, bhajan hall, everywhere. And every day morning, we used to have Swami's darshan and then go to a college. Do you know where was our college in the first year? Isharamba school, first floor. Ground floor, Isharamba. On top floor, Satya Sai Baba. So that is how the whole campus was going on. And we used to have darshan and go. One day, one pious devotee, he brought a beautiful car, 1980 model Benz car, green color. And he said, Swami, this is my humble gift to you. Please accept. Swami said, Nakinduku, Naka Karunde. Swami, please, Swami, take Swami, take Swami. No, don't waste money. I don't need all these things. I have enough. Why all that you are doing? Please, Swami. And that devotee pleaded with Swami for almost a week. Whenever Swami comes outside, this man will be on his knees and goes on praying. Just to make this gentleman happy, one day Swami called then Mr. Radhakrishna to drive the car. And then Swami came. Car was ready, green Benz. And Swami came to the slope, and there few boys were seated. Swami looked at those boys and said, Then all the boys wondering, means what? Pundra, go man, where? Swami said, get into the car. Wow! Chaos and confusion. When they said, get into the car, you find 100 fellows running into the car. And then finally, in the front, three guys sat, one on each other. And behind, four guys sat and gave a small place for our beloved Lord to adjust. And Swami, little Krishna, he goes there. He also comes that side. Hey, kuncham jaragandi. And he settled himself. And this side, doors closed. Car started. Rest of the gangsters came back. And the car glided. 15 minutes later, car comes. And who comes out of the car? Only Lord gets down from the car. Magic. Where are the boys? What happened to the boys? So we were all wondering, what happened? Then Swami came anyway, you guys have to go to college. So I dropped those guys in the classroom and I came back. He said, wow, that was great. Then we thought, lucky guys, man, lucky man. You're so lucky, man, like that. Next day, the performance repeated. The next day, performance repeated. Later on, what happened? Interview room door, and nobody sits in front of interview room door because all the boys, pillalakada, swamilas, pillalakada, near the car, not near the interview room. Because the moment they went for the signal, that's all. Everybody will be getting into the car. I thought, what a foolish guy I am. I felt I'm a very disciplined boy. You know, Swami won't like rushing, running, pushing, pulling. So I very decently was sitting. Then I thought, guy, what are you up to? You are losing a golden opportunity. Come on, man. Join the gang. Run and get into the car. Yes, self-motivated. And the third day, I also started running with the boys. But I could not match them because they had 3 days practice. I lost the race. And then finally came back with a long face. And the fourth day I decided, like that, I should be indisciplined, then only I can get into that car. The next day, even before Swami, then I also started running. Then finally what happened? Swami came and sat that side, other boys settled down, and me, my left leg inside, my left hand inside, my half body inside, the other half is outside. I'm standing like Ardhanarishwara. And Kayaldas telling, go, I want to close the door. Go in, I want to close the door. Hey, boys, please, yeah, help me, yeah, adjust, yeah, just, hey, there's no place, man, where to go? Please, yeah, he's pushing me, yeah, please, yeah. Oh, nothing is happening. Then Swami is wondering why that door is not closed and what's happening. Then Swami understood my predicament, and Swami with a beautiful smile, and he told, Ray, ippudu digu, inkoka roju nenu teesukeltanu. Now you get down. Another day I will take you. Wow. From whose mouth? Lord, he has given me assurance. Yes. Immediately I came out. Only me, the entire devotees are watching. My ego humbled myself. Slowly I walked back. But only I knew that Swami gave an assurance that he will take me. The next day, like a big shot, I'm sitting there. I was under the imagination. Swami look at me. Yesterday you missed, no? Come on, go. If when Swami says go, even if the car is full, they will give me place because it's Swami's command. So I was sitting like that, erect, getting Swami's attention. Swami came, as usual, Pundi. Everybody Pundi. I am akade kurchundi. I am sitting there only. Car went off. Are, what is this? Maybe Swami tried to, you know, patch up that day's situation. And for your information, that was the last day. And the next day, car kharab ho gaye. Car engine problem. So the whole program, the project was completed. And everybody forgot about it. And I also felt that maybe Swami just playing with me. And I also just forgot about the whole thing. I joined after my, this was my first year of studies. I finished my BCom, I finished my MCom. I joined as a teacher. And one of my colleagues was running high temperature and he wanted bread. And those days near Ganesha temple, opposite to the Ganesha gate, there is only one bakery called Sai Ganesh bakery. And that is the only place where you can get cake, bread and bun. So I took my colleague's cycle. I went there, picked up the bread and I was coming. And just yesterday, the previous day, heavily rained. And in front of the primary school, lot of sand and this and that, those things. The road also very steep and slope. Accidentally, my knee hit the handbar, right side. Because on my right hand, I'm having a loaf of bread. Left hand, I'm managing the cycle. But what happened accidentally when I hit my handbar, like a steering wheel started rotating and I went forward. Just like Hanuman is having a mountain, I am having a bread piece and straight away landed safely on the road and turned back. The cycle was doing palti, ups and downs, and the pedal of the cycle bashed me on my leg. Whether anybody is watching or not, prestige question. So immediately I got up. Then I saw on my leg, I could see white, something white. Then I knew that it was my bone. And the next thing what I saw was gushing like a fountain. What? Blood. That's all I saw. That's all I remember. When I opened my eyes, do you know where I was? In GH, Dr. Aldreja, 2-3 doctors around me, and my leg, big bandage. I said, what happened? Aldreja told me, nothing, just a hairline fracture and a ligament rupture. No, I have to go to bhajan today evening. Don't worry, Baba. I've already told Swami, here, vibhuti packet for you. So we've already informed Swami also. Yes, informed Swami. Then finally, how many days? He said, just 6 weeks. My God, 6 weeks, I can't do anywhere. No, you need a complete bread dress. And finally, students used to come to hostel for my class. Because I can't go to class, they used to come for my period. Those days, after morning lunch, after bhajan and after lunch, Swami used to go for a nice drive. That used to happen even in Vrindavan also. Swami used to take the car and go till Madras Road and come back. And beautiful darshan and a special blessings for people. People wait on the road thinking that today Swami will come, today. That's a unique experience by itself. Then what happened? In a week, at least 3 to 4 days Swami used to come. So Mr. Venkatachalam and Suryanarayana used to help me keep a Godrej chair near the gate, and I was sitting there, and invariably Swami will come. This side of the road, I am sitting. The other side of the road, mango grove, Sai Geeta was waiting. So Swami will come, bless on the other side Sai Geeta, this side Sai Surendranath. So this went on. And one day, that was Krishna Janmashtami day, and we took cycle rickshaw, and I wanted to attend that function. And Hyderabad people had come, beautiful program. And after the program, our cows and all the procession got over. And every time Swami will go to Gokulam to bless the couple, rest of the families living there, and also bless the rest of the cows and all that. So I knew that Swami will go. All the boys left to hostel. And I thought, I will snatch one more darshan. I stayed back in the bhajan hall. I knew that Swami is going to go. I thought, I'll take one more darshan. Swami finished his lunch, came out. He saw me waiting there in the prayer hall. He said, hostel ke poleda. You didn't go to hostel? I said, Swami, my cycle rickshaw is waiting. I will go, Swami. Cycle rickshaw? Yes, Swami. He is waiting outside. Enduku cycle rickshaw? Na car lo ra. Get into my car, he said. He said, get into my car? Then immediately Kail Das and Mr. Radhakrishna, they gave me a support. And Swami was walking behind me, seeing me doing that jumping. And they placed me safely inside that car. And that car was this beautiful ADA 90 Benz car. And I was made to sit in this car. What a fantastic experience. Swami came and sat that side. Behind Swami and me. No crowd. No competition. Beautiful aroma. Cool breeze. Silence inside. Because when the glasses are closed, silence inside. What a divine experience. And no security vans those days. So you can see both sides of the road, devotees standing on both sides. Some showing bye-bye. Some praying. Some asking for something. Different actions. Amazing experience. Words will fail to that. When you touch the sandalwood, your hand also will smell that. If you touch jasmine, your hand also will smell that. My divine Lord touched me that day. I were lifted to that divine experience. Amazing, amazing experience. For once I thought, I too can lift my hand and bless. To that extent, he gave me an experience. Amazing. I will never forget that. Then Swami took me to Gokulam. Swami got down. Ikade kurcho, I will come back. I sat there. Swami came back, took me to the hostel, dropped me. All the boys said, Swami, please come to the hostel. Please come to the hostel. Swami said, no. No, your warden didn't call me. If your warden don't call, how can I come? Your warden should call me. Some excuse. So immediately, no, Swami. Warden said, Swami, please. No, I didn't come to your hostel. I just came to leave this guy here. So get down. I also said, Swami, please come. Hey, noor muskini digu, he said. Shut up and get down. I said, okay, fine. I got down, went to my room. I was a hero that day in front of all my classmates and all that. And then back of my mind, the word, hey, దిగు, నిన్ను ఇంకొక రోజు తీసుకువెళ్తాను. బాయ్, గెట్ డౌన్, ఐ విల్ టేక్ యూ అనదర్ డే. దట్ ఈస్ సత్య, ఈస్ మై ప్రచా. హిస్ వర్డ్స్ విల్ నెవర్ ఎవర్ ఫెయిల్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు సరెండర్ టు హిమ్. ఇట్ టుక్ 5 years, 4 to 5 years ఫర్ మీ. ఐ ఫర్ గాట్, బట్ డివైన్ లార్డ్ విల్ నెవర్ ఫర్గెట్. ప్లీజ్, హీ ఈజ్ అవర్ స్వీటెస్ట్ లార్డ్ అండ్ వీఆర్ లక్కీ టు హ్యావ్ హిమ్. ఫైన్, క్విక్లీ గో టు ధర్మ ఈస్ మై ఆచార్. ధర్మ ఈస్ మై ఆచార్. హియర్ ఐ షుడ్ సే, స్వామి ఆల్వేస్ ఫాలోస్ హిస్ ఓన్ ధర్మ. స్వామి నెవర్ ఎవర్ changes. No, he sticks to that. One day when I was sitting there, a small group was called for interview. An old man was in the wheelchair, and Swami told that old man, hey, get up and walk. He said no. Then Swami said, no, get up and walk. Then the family members came closer to Swami. Swami, 10 years he never walked, Swami. I am telling, walk. And Swami came close, patted on both the heads, both their legs, and then gave a hand support just to pull him. Lo and behold, this gentleman was standing, and Swami took along with him inside the interview room. He started walking, and the terrific clap from the crowd. But the family members were utterly confused. They didn't know it's a day dream or reality. But the guy with the wheelchair felt that this man will collapse. He may fall on Swami. So still he went, followed that old man with the wheelchair inside the interview room. 1 hour over, interview over. All of us were eagerly waiting. What is going to happen now? Swami took him inside the interview room and he walked. Now what? Not me. All the people who were gathered there with 1,000 eyes, they are eagerly seeing not Swami but the door. One by one, family people were coming. This old man didn't come. We're wondering what happened. He settled inside or what? Then Swami came. Behind Swami, this gentleman comes. Do you know how he comes? He is pushing his own wheelchair and coming out of the interview room. Swami's dharma is to protect his devotees. Nothing can stop between God and devotee, provided if devotee surrenders to the will of God. I would like to narrate one of our personal experience. This is the place where I was nailed down into family life. This place gave me a lot of memories. My parents and me were standing there. Swami came and he told me, hey, pendli chesko. We all know, mischievous Swami, in front of parents, he will talk like that. So parents feel very happy. So I knew Swami is playing that game. Just to make my parents happy, hey, pendli chesko, pendli chesko. I said, no pendli. No, chesko. I said, no pendli. My mother, like a small girl, she has seen Swami, and she is very free and frank with Baba. He said, Swami, my son tells me that if he gets married, you will keep maintain distance and you will not talk to him. Who said? This fellow said, hey, you're not just nana. Am I doing like that? I was looking at my mother, what is this? Why do you set fire directly? As it is, Swami is fire, and on top of it you're pouring ghee. What is this? I was thinking. I just put my head down, and then Swami said, Srinivas pendli cheskuni na daggara pettukoledu, Shiva Pandit pendli cheskuni na daggara pettukoledu, అలాగే నీవు కూడా పెళ్లి చేసుకుని నా దగ్గర పెట్టుకుంటాను. నేను నిన్ను పంపను పంపను పంపను. దెన్ ఈ ఆశ్వర్ అక్షింత కళ్యాణ ప్రాప్తి రస్తు బ్లా 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 వన్ శ్లోక హి టోల్డ్ అండ్ సెడ్ టేక్ నమస్కార్. దట్స్ ఆల్ దేర్. ఇట్ వాస్ అ కమాండ్. ఐ హ్యాడ్ నో చాయిస్. ఐ సెడ్ ఓకే ఫైన్. ఐ జస్ట్ కెప్ క్వైట్. వీ విల్ సీ వెన్ ఇట్ హ్యాపన్స్. అండ్ దేర్ వీ హ్యావ్ ద బ్యూటిఫుల్ ట్రీ రౌండ్ సాయిరామ్ షెడ్ దేర్. దెన్ మై వుడ్ బి వైఫ్ వాస్ డూయింగ్ డ్యూటీ. And to her, Swami goes and tells, get married. And she says, no, I don't want to get married. I love doing service. I ring Balavika's children. I'm doing service and sweeping. I'm happy about it. I want to be like that. I don't want to get married. Swami said, no, you drive all the way from your house and you come here and doing service. But I want you to be with me. I will give you my boy and you will marry him so that you can stay with me and not coming and going every day. What an offer. Anybody will fall that for the offer. Immediately this poor lady said, fine. Here command, and there it is demand. And finally, we are here as a beautiful couple blessed by Bhagavan Baba. In 2004, my wife suddenly told me, I'm having back pain, back pain, back pain. I said, maybe a catch or something of that kind. So whatever is possible, infrared, iodex, whatever is possible, Oviran, we are all doctors by a natural process. So we apply everything from the medical shop that is available. But unfortunately, the pain didn't subside, but pain started aggravating day by day. And one fine morning, she just could not get up from bed. She was crying. Sorry, I'm not able to get up. I don't know what happened. I had to literally lift her, make her sit. And there was a time where she will eat her lunch and breakfast lying on the bed. Her mother said, why don't you come here? We will show to doctor. Her immense faith in Swami, she said, no, Swami is here. He will take care. I don't want to come home. And me, as a husband, I have my duty to take care of wife. So what little I can do, I was doing. But a day came, it was too bad, and she was crying whole night, and we never had good sleep. I requested Dr. Sundareshan from Bangalore. They used to come there for Swami's darshan. And Dr. Vardachari from US, he was also orthopedic surgeon, they used to come. I went and requested, sir, my wife's condition is like this. I don't know what happened. Can you, in the GH, they are not able to diagnose. Can you just help me out? Such a beautiful person. I love them. I have great regard for Dr. Sundareshan and Dr. Vardachari even today. Such a humble, loving people. I just requested, they came all the way to my house. And then she was lying down, and doctor just touched the toe. The moment they touched the toe, she started screaming. And then he did orthopedic doctors, you know what all they're doing. Then he said, hey, something wrong with the spine, man. It is not a catch or a sprain. Something wrong with the spine. So you get MRI done. I'm coming in another 2 days. Get the report, put it in a CD. I will see in the computer and let you know what to do next. I said, okay, fine. Everything was done in Bangalore Hospital. Brought the CD, this gentleman came, saw the CD and confirmed saying L4, L5 prolapsed disc. And it is touch crushing a nerve and that is called some sciatica and she started left leg being numb. It is numb, she is not feeling that I have a leg, you know, like that kind of feeling she's having that time. And then he saw that, hey, what are you doing? She's a young girl, man, don't leave her like this. I said, doctor, what I should do? She needs a surgery. If you leave like that and ignore, she'll be on the wheelchair for life. Don't do that. She has life. I said, yes, but how? In JH Whitefield, I will perform the surgery. I will organize everything. You bring her carefully. I said, doc, I can't do that. I first have to get okay from Swami. Without Swami's permission, I won't do anything. I said, fine, go ahead. But tell Swami, this is the exact cause and this is the exact problem. I wrote a letter, but myself and my wife reluctantly wrote a letter. Do you know why? That was the time Swami himself was not able to walk. I felt, damn it, how I can go and ask Lord, Swami, my wife is having, she's having pain and she's not able to walk. How can I ask? But the situation, circumstance demanded. Then I was forced to do that. And I went there. The duty boy came, took the letter. The boy came back with 11 vibhuti packets and nothing more. Fine. I gave the vibhuti packet. She was very happy. At least Swami responded and gave vibhuti packet. Evening, I went and sat there. And Swami, that day, came early. Swami looked at me. Hey, he said. I got up and rushed. Yela undi, ni bharya. I said, Swami, she's having a lot of pain. She's crying out of pain. She's not able to move her limb. And she's lying down and I'm feeding her breakfast and lunch, Swami. I know, I know. And Swami said, doctors em chepparu. Swami, L4, L5 prolapse disc, some sciatic nerve. So she needs immediate surgery. Swami looked at the ceiling for some time, holding the boy in that angle. No surgery. No surgery. Tell her no surgery. Tell her Swami will take care. And he created Vibhuti and gave me. Go, put half into her mouth and take other half and rub from here. I never described anything on the letter, but exactly Swami explained to me which leg and from where to where. That is the beauty of our Divine Lord. So he told me from here to there, you just apply. I will take care. No surgery. Tell her not to worry. I went and said, Buddhi ledu. Ippude poi. Then I rushed. I did that, whatever Swami wanted. I came back. Everything was okay. That night she had dinner. We were sleeping. And exactly in the middle of the night, I'm always while she sleeping, subconsciously I used to think of her, because anything she wants only I have to do, because she can't do anything. She wants water, whatever it is. Suddenly, I heard a loud noise. If you take a dry drumstick twig and if you break it, what type of sound you will hear? Crack. That was the loud noise. I heard crack. When I heard that, I jumped from the cot, switched on the light. Ah, this girl has done something nonsense. The spine is broken now, because everybody is telling spine, spine, spine. After hearing that noise, I said, damn it, this girl broke her spine. Finished, I said. Then when I switched on the light, she was looking, open eyes. Did you hear? Damn it. I heard, that's why no, I switched on the light. What you did? No, I didn't do anything. I just wanted to turn. That noise came. I said, how are you? In this position, everything is fine. No pain. I said, Baba, 12:30 in the night, whom I will get, from where I will get, and what I will do. Only thing just now I can do is stuff you with all the pillows, my pillows and all that. Please sleep like a small baby in the same angle till morning 5 o'clock. And she obeyed. And she slept in the same angle, because we never know any more further movement, tilt. We don't know what is going to happen. We didn't know exactly to explain the situation. That was the day. After so many months, me and my wife slept a very sound sleep. And my college starts at 9 o'clock and this gentleman gets at 8:45. When he opens eyes, I think 8:45, damn it, 8:45, I'm already late. I have to get up, heat the milk, make the coffee, give breakfast, feed her, and I have to run. Then I saw this girl was sleeping peacefully. I didn't want to disturb. Finished my morning duty and I came. How are you feeling? So far, so good. I said, okay, can you brush? Can I bring the bucket here? She said, I'll try to sit. She sat. Then she shifted. I put 3 stools to go to bathroom. 1 step, 1 stool, 2nd step, 2nd stool, 3rd step, 3rd stool, 4th, inside the bathroom, brushing. She came back and sat. I said, fine, I don't know what happened and what was that noise, but no pain. Yeah, pain is there, but she's able to sit and she's able to move slowly. And our doctor comes after 3 days. Hey, what did Swami say? I said, Swami said, no surgery. He created Vibhuti and he told me to do this. And that night, this is what happened. Okay, I will check her. She's lying down. Same toe, 3 days back, what he touched. No reaction. She's calm and cool. Then he held, lifted up. 1 foot she could raise. After that, she started screaming, ah, like that. Then he put the leg and said, hey, something has happened, yeah. In 3 days, something has happened. This girl was shouting and screaming when I touched, but now she's able to lift for 1 foot, means something has happened. Anyway, she's not my patient. She's Baba's patient. And I can't touch her. At the most, what I can do is, I can give you a painkiller, but I am ready. Anytime you ask me, I am ready to do the surgery. I said, thank you very much, sir. So this is how Dr. Vadachari and Dr. Sundareshan, quite often they used to ask, even today when they come, they remember her and remember me and ask, how is your wife and how is your wife? 2004. And Swami told, don't come for darshan. I will tell you when she should come for darshan. And one day, on November 18th, I still remember, Swami called me to the interview room, gave me a sari and told, give this to your wife, tell her to wear this sari and come for my darshan on November 19th, Ladies' Day. And she came, Swami gave a beautiful smile and blessing. Till date, 10 years over, there she is, sound, safe, healthy, doing everything by herself. But only one thing is, she cannot sit down. She needs to sit on the chair. That is our Lord. So this is how you find such beautiful things Swami did. And we used to have a wonderful session with Swami. And one day when Swami was joking with us, suddenly I was doing Padaseva, and Swami showed me his leg. Hey, chudra na kaalu enta vachipoyindi. You see, my legs are swollen. That day, I summoned courage and I told Swami, you made people walk. You cured many diseases. You say cancer cancelled and you brought back dead to life. When everything that you can do, Swami, we feel sad and upset to see you like this. Swami, why can't you cure yourself? And then Swami very beautifully said, Ray, how can I do that? I can't do that. And Swami very beautifully said, I don't feel the pain. I don't have any attachment with my body. I created this nature and I also need to follow this nature. And a beautiful example instantaneously Swami gave. Police vadu telusa, traffic police vadu. He makes the rule and he also follows the rule. He is no exception. Similarly, I also need to follow. And if I start curing myself, Swami, very beautiful statement he said, what is the difference between you and me if I use nature for my own purpose? That is dharma. That is dharma, acharana. Dharma is my, okay, that day, Swami, what we could do for you? Swami said, only your prayers are my cure. Our love is a solace. Our love is his comfort. Even in worst of the condition, Swami always followed his dharma and he never violated that. He is an example, living example. That is what Krishna did. That is what Rama also did. Don't tell me Rama not aware that Ravana only kidnapped his wife. He could have, next second he could have done something and Sita would have been back. Then Ramayana will be only 10 pages. It will not be such a thick book. But it has to happen. And that is the beauty of our Lord. Shanti is my swabhav. Yes, that's a beautiful thing. My experience with this aspect of Swami. Beautiful sessions we used to have in Bhajan Hall. Beautiful sessions we used to have in Bhajan Hall. And one day, when we are waiting, Swami didn't turn up for darshan. It was almost 10 minutes for bhajan. We didn't know why Swami, you know, not coming for darshan and all that. Just 5 minutes before bhajan, the darshan music started. Swami started moving and Swami started walking away from the devotees and not closer to the devotees. He didn't pick up any letter or anything, just smiling and waving and, you know, giving them solace and comfort. And cut short, he did not go to the gen side. Straight away, he came into the bhajan hall. And he entered the bhajan hall. On the fifth row, one boy was sitting and Swami was standing and talking to the boy. So second row boy wanted to snatch a quick, lovely namaskar. So slowly he was sliding his hand to touch Swami's lotus feet. And Swami, like that he did, don't do. Okay, that boy kept quiet. After some more time, once again he thought he will try. Hey, no. Swami very sternly said, hey, no, Swami said. I understood the gravity of the situation. So immediately I signaled to that boy, don't do, don't upset Swami. Leave him free. He's talking to somebody behind. Don't disturb him, I told. Our beautiful Lord Krishna watched this through corner of his eyes. That me talking to that guy and signaling that guy. After the conversation is over, he straight comes in front of me, lifting his angi, his robe, and he said, touch. What? Swami said, touch. There that guy was trying to touch. He said, no. And here the Lord comes and stands in front of me and say, touch. I didn't know what to do. I said, okay, I have to obey his command. So I touched his feet. Do you know what was the shocking thing? He was hot. More than warm. Then Swami looked at me and told, Ninna ninchi naku jaramura, Swami told. From yesterday, I am having running temperature. That is why I came late for darshan. I said, Swami, we can do bhajan and we will give aarti. Swami, you go and take rest. Rey, meeku casual leave, medical leave, anni leave unnai. Sai Baba ki leave le ledu. No holidays for Sai Baba. Sai Baba all the time working day only, every day. Do you know why? These devotees, they come for one darshan, they come for one day, they spend a lot of time just to want to see me, just to want to have a glimpse of me, just to honor that love, just to show, reciprocate that love. I come and give them darshan. That is my duty. And I saw two red lines on his lotus feet. I asked Swami, what are those red lines? Swami said, oh, Adiya, when I walk among the ladies' side, some ladies will have long, long nails. And they snatch Pada Namaskaram and scratch my leg. And some of them will have sharp bangles that also will come. And Swami, in spite of the temperature, he was started joking and saying, hey, idi matram kadu, not only this, you will find kumkum, sticker, lipsticks, all sorts of nonsense on my leg. And after darshan, I have to wash my leg like that. But do you know why? They are pure. Their love is pure. They just wanted to touch and take namaskar. I don't say anything. Though it hurts me, I never tell anything to them. What does that mean? Shanti is my swabhav. That was his demonstration of that peace in him, that he never hurts anybody. The next one, Sai projects. All of us know, we have medical wing, educational, and water. One day in Kodaikanal, Colonel Jogara was sitting there with a long face. And Swami, Jubilian Swami in Kodaikanal, he was also like a student, coming out of his room. Hey, Jogara, emi dull ga unnavu? He said, what Jogara, why are you dull? Em ledu Swami. No. Emi, chappu, what is the problem? Why are you know, something disturbing you? Something was in his mind. He thought this is an opportunity, just come out. He said, Swami, the problem is, you stand in this course and you tell, next year, super special hospital in Puttaparthi, first operation will take place. And simply you tell, next year, do you know, to construct a super special hospital, we have to purchase land, we have to build building, we have to bring technology, we have to appoint doctor, we have to get the surgeon, we have to hunt for a patient. Do you know such a long process? Such a long process, and simply you say, next birthday there will be surgery in my hospital. Next birthday this will happen. What is this, Swami? We need money. We need time. You can't tell like that openly. Do you know what Swami said? Oh, adha problem. Who announced that? You made the announcement or I made the announcement? Of course you made the announcement. Then what is your problem? The problem is mine. I only announced. I should feel bad. But why are you feeling bad? Swami, how this will happen? Swami Sankalpam Vajra Sankalpam. If Swami decides, nothing will go wrong. Swami told him, you just play your role. Everything will be taken care. That's what happened. Next birthday, hospital was ready in war footing. And the first surgery was also done. And our Lord will not keep quiet. Like a small child excited, next year I'm going to give you water. Oh my God. It is testing the trust of central trust people. Really. It is not an easy joke to live with God. Please take it from me. Living with God is living with fire. The amount of love that you enjoy, this kind of love, trust people or people who are very close to Swami, trust me, they will not get it. They are always on their toes. But still, our beloved Lord voiced his opinion, and the hard work should go on. And the time came, short of funds. For your information, this campus was mortgaged. This Tri Brindavan was mortgaged with Canara Bank and got loan for this project. Of course, project was successful, project was completed. But why Baba has to do this? Do you think Baba never had money? Do you think Baba cannot get money? Do you think people are not there to give money? If only Swami opens his mouth and say, I need money, rupees and euros and dollars will be raining cats and dogs in Prashanti Nilayam. It will be raining. But our sweet Lord is never like that. Never like that. He never asks anybody. Or he could have gone to Singapore, Malaysia, Australia, Japan, anywhere and ask for money. One round is enough. Not only in Andhra Pradesh, for entire India he can give water supply. But Baba didn't do. Do you know why? Swami any number of times told, my hand is always giving and giving and giving. My hand is never at the bottom. My hand is always on top. Please understand, God comes to give, but not to take. We come to take, but seldom give. That is the difference between God and man. So therefore, Swami said, I will never ever ask anybody, but don't worry, everything will be fine. Everything will be accomplished in course of a time. Remember, boys, Swami is like a sugar candy. For a sugar candy, ants will come from all corner, but sugar candy will never go towards the ants. Will it go? It will never go. That faith and that conviction that you must have, he had. If you or me would have taken that project and find a big hole in our pocket, we would have admitted in the mental hospital with high BP and sugar, like that. But he is Shanta Swarupa. Nothing affects him. Sweet Lord. Everything was accomplished. And after completing of this project, Swami called the state and he wants to hand over to the state to take over. This project, please remember, even government failed to do that. British government called this place as backward region. B-A-C-K. Bellary, Anantapur, Kadapa, Karnool. Conveniently, backward region. Rubber stamped by Britishers and an Indian rulers. But Lord of Lord, he made it forward. He made it happen. And he gave sweet drinking water to all that lakhs and lakhs of devotees. That day when he was handing over, mark my words, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu was the chief guest. And Swami handed over to them. Do you know, he's a politician. Do you know what statement came from his mouth? He said, do you think your Baba is not having money? He is having plenty of money. If he wants, he can get more and more money. He need not mortgage his property to get money and to complete this project. It is for you and me to understand, for a good cause, don't ever hesitate even to mortgage your private property. That is the message that your Sai Baba is giving to all devotees, he said. Amazing statement from a politician. And everything was cleared, completed, projects handover, of course, Tri Brindavan back to us. That is the sweet Lord. Shanti is my swabhav. What is the difference between God and man? God, man can cut an apple and he says, with R&D, research and development, he says, sir, I cut the apple and there were 11 seeds. In that apple, there were 14 seeds. Wow, what an invention. But do you know what God can do? That is a limitation of a man. Do you know what God can do? He can take that one seed and he can count the number of apples that can come from out of that one seed. That is the divine. That is the limitation of man. And that is the greatness of God. That's why Swami always says, where science end, spirituality starts. Cutting the apple, counting, science end. But he can't cut the seed and count the way God can count the number of apples that can come from that seed. So therefore, my dear students, we are so lucky and so fortunate to be here as part of his institution. Just living with him itself is a big lesson. Living with him is great revelation. Living with him makes our life holy and glorified. And the last one, prema is my swaroop. A beautiful one. 77, when I joined this hostel, and then Mr. Sudarshanam and Dr. Lakshmi Narasimhan was the warden. I said, sir, I want to be part of summer course. Please allow me to stay. No, boy, no. Go back home. Special invitation will come. If you get a letter only, you can come. Sir, please, sir. I want to join, sir. You go. If Swami blesses, your name also will be selected. Don't worry. So finally, the call letter came. And the first time, I was traveling alone from Chennai to Bangalore. And that time, I never ever, I don't know the route of this place. I can't speak Kannada. And I don't know how to reach this place. So my parents very strictly, door-to-door map they gave. Get down in railway station, city. From there, you catch a bus and go to city market. In city market, 319 bus will be there. Get into 319 bus and ask Kadugodi. And get down in Kadugodi. That is the last stop. And then you go to hostel. I said, okay, Papa, okay, Mama, done. And I was in the train, Bangalore Express. The funniest part of that Bangalore Express will stop in Malur, just one station this side, can stop in Krishnarajapuram, one station this side, Whitefield, it never stops. So the train came, in Malur all the employees got in, they were hanging on the sides of the train, and I saw from that time, now too many buildings, that time no buildings, you can see very nicely the entire area. Full of festoons and color lights and series lights and, you know, fully decorated. I saw all that. Swami, you are here. I have to go to city market and then catch a bus and come. If only if this train can stop for 1 minute, I can jump out of the train. Swami, you are very near, yet very far for me. This is the stray thought came in my mind. And I saw the station rushing by. And the station master showing the green flag. Lo and behold, suddenly the train brake was jammed as if somebody pulled the chain. Do you know what happened? My compartment exactly stopped on the road of the gate. Now the bridge is there. That time my compartment stopped there. I asked the guy, why the train stopped? Signal ba, signal kotilla. How long it will stop? Gotilla. Are kottilla, gottilla, what to do now? Then I want to get down. Jump, he said. My luggage is there. Which one? That green suitcase, that bag and this bedding. You jump, we will give. Okay, I jumped. Then panicky. Suddenly if train starts, my luggage will go. Now what will happen? Luckily, all those guys helped me and they threw my baggage and my bedding and my box, everything. Do you know? I am the only hero out of the train. I turned from the left to right. Only one man with luggage I got down. I said, okay, fine. I'm out of the train with my luggage. I came here, went to the office to registration, for registration. And warden said, have you had your dinner? No, sir. First you have your dinner and then you can register. No harm, no worry. So I left the bag there in the office, went, picked up my food and closed my eyes to chant Brahmarpanam. Om Pam. When I'm chanting Om, I'm hearing Pam. That train was till then there only. Fantastic. Very good. I came back next day morning for darshan and Swami came out, straight looked into my eyes like that. A very, understanding smile and a look. How was it? Like that. We are close, yet we are far. For Swami, nothing is far and no one is far. If you, The distance between God and you is the same distance between you and God and you. So it's a distance is doesn't matter for God. You just have to feel him from your heart and he will fill all your desire. That was a beautiful training incident during summer course. Another small incident. Summer course time, thousand and odd people. Those days summer course will go for 3 weeks, 4 weeks. And we all were given the opportunity to cut the vegetables and make chapatis. And we used to get up 3 o'clock and start cutting. Do you know it's not 1 kg or 2 kg? 30 kg potato, 30 kg onion, you are like eye drops. Your eye will be always fresh and clean. Cutting onions and cutting brinjals and potato and what not. All nothing less than 30 kgs. All of us we do. On top of it, rolling chapati. 1,000 people, 1,000 chapatis. Even if you give one chapati, we have to roll. And boys, not one day, boy. It is for 3 to 4 weeks. We have to do the same job again and again. And we cannot miss the class. We have to sit there. So we have to go and attend the class. And evening Swami's discourse, come back here again. A hectic task. The lady campus felt that they also want to do something. And they asked Swami, Swami, please give us opportunity, we'll also do. Swami said, Ma pillal chestunnar kada. Somewhere they have to put a break. He said, Swami, chapatis are not good, Swami. Why chapatis are not good? Yeah, it's all like different shapes, Swami. Like Africa, America, Japan, like that. And they don't fry properly, Swami. Guest and all feeling little bad to eat because Swami's prasadam they are eating. But otherwise, if you give that opportunity, our girls can do much better. Swami is not one mother's love. 1,000 mothers love. Swami can shout at you. He can thrash you, he can bash you. That is because you are his property. But if anybody comments about his boys, he just cannot take it. So, he went off and he was telling warden, what is this? Ladies are all complaining. Me pillal sarige cheyaledani. Etla cheptamu pillalki? How can I tell boys? You koncha chusko. We overheard the conversation. Immediately we had a serious discussion. In that discussion, one of our boy bulb glue. What he said? Hey, a very simple idea, man. He said, what? I will go to Kadugudi and buy 5 tiffin boxes. In each tiffin box, we have lid and we have the base. You make Africa, America, Russia, whatever you want, you make. Tuck, tuck, tuck. When you do, perfect the round, man. Wow, that's amazing guy, man. Amazing. Immediately, sir, please give me permission, sir. We want to go to Kadugudi. Why you want to go to Kadugudi? No permission. You can't get out of the campus. You all know that. No permission. Sir. Swami, I felt Swami is feeling very bad and everybody is complaining. I know. Do it slowly. No. Sir, do it slowly means today chapati, tomorrow only they can eat 1,000 chapatis. So what to do? Then immediately said, sir, this is the idea. When we said the idea, his eyes were twinkling. Wow, that's great. Then he said, okay, go and get. So we rushed to Kadugudi. Same size tiffin box, 5 we brought. So we can immediately mechanized, standardized product. So we are ready to do that. And then chapati is ready. Sir, Africa, America, Russia, Canada, whatever you want you do. Don't worry about that. Then some boys, tuck, tuck, tuck. The other boy will take the extra, crush it again roll. Tuck, tuck, tuck. That evening, Swami came. Vadan also was very clever. He didn't open his mouth. And he also wants to surprise Swami. Because the complaint, no, Swami is very, very inquisitive in nature. Maya Nataka Sutradari. He will never, he knows what is what. But he came straight away to the counter. He opened what? Chapati vessel only. To see what all the countries are put into that box. And to utter surprise, he found everything round. Hey, Vadan. Mana pillal chala baga chesare. Our boys did very well. And then Swami took to the lady's side. You see the perfection, it is like moon. Everything is uniform. Even ladies cannot do like that. Yes! We did it. That is the love. Prema is my swaroop. That is why Swami loves his boys. Anything you ask, we are ready to do. And he has such confidence in boys that boys will never ever falter. They can go to any extreme and become Einstein to invent, make best of the things. So that was the chapati incident. Because one boy jokingly said, "Hey, you make Russia, you make Japan, you make China. From any country, what you see is moon, which is always in same round shape. That I will make." So each boy was in one country. From all the countries, boys started making same moon like chapati. Okay, fine. Before wind up, I will go to the last one. When I joined Purthi, first batch, I was given various tasks. I was to look after the bhajan group, and I used to look after the altar, and I used to look after collecting the fees. So many extra activities I used to do. One day Warren called me after Swami's dinner. Usually they come around 8 o'clock or so. One day Swami called me Warden called me to his room, and he told me, "Hey boy, Swami wanted me to inform that you don't have to pay your fees, your college fees or your hostel fees, nothing you need to pay. And Swami also told me specifically, don't ever ask even one paisa from your parents. And Swami told, he is like my son. Tell him I will take care, but he should never ask even one paisa from his parents." I said, it was a pleasant surprise. I didn't know how to react. I said, okay, Swami says, he's my son and I will take care and I will look after everything. I said, yes, sir. And tomorrow morning, sit in the front row and take his blessings. That was a tradition those days. I sat, I took namaskar, and Swami said, "Nenu ninnu chusukuntanu, I will take care of you." Mind you, I told my parents, from that day, I never ever asked even one paisa. Every month, Swami used to send pocket money. Then Warren used to come and give me an envelope saying that, "Swami is so loving towards you. Swami counts those days 500 and 1,000. Like those days, 500,000 is a big money. So he used to put and lick the envelope, paste it. Vadiki jagartaga ee. Idi faadu vadiki barbariki, dobiki, chappu." So Warden will come and repeat the same thing. "This is for your barber and for your dobi and for your soap and paste." I said, "Thank you, sir." That is how this loving Lord, that is why Swami says, my love is not one mother, 1,000 mother. I experienced that from this divine Lord. So 1,000 mothers love. So that is how Swami looked after me for Guru Purnima, for birthday and for Dasara. Swami used to call me and give me clothes and stitching charges. I never asked anything. I never opened my mouth and asked Swami also, because even before I could ask, Swami used to give me everything. And that is how Swami took care of me, and I completed my education, and I gave me job, and my first salary Swami fixed it was 800 rupees when I joined. So loving, so kind. Where do you find that kind of a personality in this? To be part of that, to be experiencing that kind of love, I tell you, words will fail. And it's a humbling experience. I am always indebted to Lord. Because of him, I am standing in front of you today. Otherwise, I have nothing with me. An intelligent person will open your mind. A beautiful person will open your eyes. A loving, kind person will open your heart. He is that loving Lord. He opens everyone's heart. Be ready and accept and invite him to do that. Our prayers. Satya Dharma Shanti Prema Sabuko Dijo. Satya Dharma Shanti Prema Swarupa Aap Hai. Satya Dharma Shanti Prema Jeevan Ka Marma Hai. Gurudev, Gurudev. My topic was Satya, Dharma, Shanti and Prema. That was his Swarup. and he lived up to it till the last. Satya is my prachar, dharma is my achar, shanti is my swabhav, prema is my swarup. What he gave years back till date, he keeps up his word. That one is not enough to prove that is none other than divine himself. I want to complete by a small situation analysis. God always sees your performance, but not your position. There are two guys, one taxi driver and a priest. They left the body, soul went up. And you know that our ledgers are maintained very well there, on top, higher levels. And the taxi driver was called. And this man with the jeans pant and fantastic t-shirt and goggles is walking. They asked, who are you? Then he said, I'm so-and-so, I'm Mr. X, taxi driver in Bangalore. Wow. You opened the book. Fantastic. Very good. And then come here. And they gave a silk robe and a golden crown and told him, yes, sir, please go this side. Priest was watching all this. Are, for a taxi driver in Bangalore, silk clothes and golden crown and all, I'm a priest. What I can expect? So he started calculating. His turn came. He said, who are you? I'm a pandit. Wow, where? Bangalore, of course. Then one ledger was opened. They saw the accounts. And then there comes a cotton shawl and a cricket cap. Then he said, sir, I'm a pandit. Yes, sir. Of course, correct. That's what you deserve. Then he thought, only in Kali Age downstairs, some kind of bungling goes in accounts. Here also it is happening. Eh? So he wanted to confirm. He said, sir, I have a doubt. Yes, please go ahead. The taxi driver, when he came, you gave a golden shawl and golden everything and a royal welcome you gave. And for me, you are not doing anything. Oh, that's your doubt. That's very simple, dear Pandit. You know this taxi driver in Bangalore, whenever anybody sits and he wants to take as many passengers as possible on a particular day, and he's a very rash driver, and he closes his eyes and zooms on the road, and the passenger behind feels that, damn it, I will not reach my destination, but I will be going up. So immediately, Rama, 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 Rama. And then, Abba, finally I reach in one full piece. He gets down. Another passenger gets up. Same experience. Krishna, 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 Krishna. He gets up. Another goes, Allah, Allah, Allah. Another goes, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Like this, he brought thousands and thousands of passengers closer to God. Otherwise, these people wouldn't have ever thought with that intensity. He did, even without his knowledge, he brought God and devotee together. That is why he deserves. What, sir? You know, I'm a pandit. This taxi driver, one passenger, two passenger, he made them say, chant Rama, Krishna, Govinda, whatever it is. Do you know, when I talk, hundreds and hundreds of people watch and listen. That means, what should be my condition? Yes, Pandit, I agree. But the only problem is, when you are talking, all were sleeping. That is a problem. So therefore, in our life, if you seriously see, what is that we need to do? That's why God sees the performance and God never sees your position. In the last, I want to wind up saying, today's takeaway for all of us. When you're going from here, this should be part and parcel of your system, in your mind, and I hope that you will practice a little bit here and there. What is a statement? Today's takeaway from here, what you have is not your wealth, but what you do for others is your real wealth. Just seriously think about it. To make this even more clear, there is a beautiful story called The Suitcase. One man died and the guard was waiting for him with a suitcase in his hand. He said, my dear, welcome, come, come. God, where? Your time is up. What? Time is up? Of course. All your work on the earth is finished. Come on, let's move forward. My Lord, I have lots of plans. All my files are pending. So many things yet to accomplish. Please, don't do that. Give me some time. No, my dear, time is up and we need to go. Then he didn't know what to do. God, what is in that suitcase? Is it my belongings? He said, my clothes, my wallets, my credit card, debit card. Did you bring that for our next journey? Then God says, hello, those things all belong to earth. It doesn't belong to this place. Then is it my family and friend you packed them? No, they belong to the path in which you walked. Is it my wife and my son? No, they never belong to you. They belong to your heart. Is it my memories? No, my dear. Your memories belong to time. Okay, is it my body? No, my dear. Your body belongs to dust. Then is it my soul at least? My dear, your soul is mine. Damn it. Then what is mine? And what do I have? My dear child, open the suitcase and see what you have. He rushed and opened his suitcase and he finds tears rolling by. His suitcase was empty. And then God answered, this is empty because every moment you lived only for yourself. You never did anything for others. So what you have is not yours. What you do for others is your real wealth. This is what Swami has been explained. And Swami says, my life is my message. And he did all through his life. And today, still we remember, it is because this is what he did. And that is what we should follow. And I hope and pray, brothers and sisters and my dear students, wherever we go, whatever is possible within our limitations, please do something. See a smile on other side. See a sparkling eyes on the other side and derive great joy.
Pedda property college pillale primary school college higher secondary school pillalanta kuda na venta ventane untuntaru allu vadali vaaru poru vaari vadali nenu undalenu andaru manchi bangaru నా పిల్లల యొక్క పరిస్థితి నాకు తెలుసు కానీ మరొకరు తెలియదు. పిల్లలందరూ కూడాను స్వామి అంటే ప్రాణమిస్తున్నారు. అందువలన వారికి నేను ఎప్పుడైనా సరే నేను వారిని ప్రాణ సంరక్షణ చేస్తాను. పిల్లలందరూ కూడా సుక్షేమంగా జీవించాలి. మీరు ఎక్కడుండినా కూడాను నేను వెంట జంట ఇంట ఉంటాను. రేపటి నుంచి కూడాను మీరు ఏ పని చేసినా కానీ ఇది స్వామి పని, స్వామి పని, స్వామి పని అనుకుని.
దిస్ ఇస్ ద బ్యూటిఫుల్ ప్లేస్ where after the tri session is over, when Swami is going to retire, he says, very, very happy and good night to all. We relive those days and it is meant for all of us today. Thank you very much. Team Samarpan, fantastic, great job, amazing coordination, hard work behind. I pray Swami to bless you all and make this a grand success and touch millions and millions of heart. What you are doing, you don't know that what you are doing. In this gathering, definitely through Samarpan, at least 10 hearts we should have touched. We might have touched. We might have given that joy to another 100. We might have made them think another 100. That is our effort. Rest. Yatna prayatnamu manava dharmamu. Jayapajayamu Daivadinamu. Let us make the effort and the results we leave it to Swami. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. I'm sorry I have taken 15 minutes extra. Please pardon me. I hope you will do that. And I hope you will all enjoy and carry some message from Samarpan today. And I'm thanking Samarpan team to invite me here and to make me relive and make me rethink and enjoy those wonderful moments with Bhagavan Baba. Before we wind up, I just want 3 more minutes. We'll all be with God for just 3 minutes. A lovely video.
ఈ ఫ్యూచర్ ఈ ప్రెజెంట్ నేను చూసుకుంటాను. నాకు వేరే స్థానం ఎక్కడ లేదు. మీ హృదయాలే నా యొక్క స్థానం.
Thank you very much. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. God bless you all. Sai Ram.